Once again, thank you for taking the time to attend the webinar today. We're very, very excited with the progress that we have been making, as well as the significant interest that we have seen in the PTA communities across the nation. Since our private beta launch in April, we entered into collaboration with the Washington State PTA, and we have now close to 240 PTAs that have signed up, evaluating, and some of them have already started launching. So we're very excited with the interest and the response that we have seen. So specifically, this webinar is intended to make sure that those communities that are already on Bloomz and in the process of launching, we want to make sure that we help you in all ways possible based on some of the best practices we have learned and also the new resources and progress that we have made both on the product side as well as our support and resources. So with that, let me get started with, in fact, what I'm showing you right now is a PowerPoint resource that we in fact shared with all the members. The purpose of this PowerPoint is quickly to summarize to your board, or the teachers, or any other members that would like to understand what Bloomz brings to your community. This will just allow you to articulate the value of Bloomz for your community. So a quick, in one line, if I were to summarize what is Bloomz, our Bloomz intent to be the simplest app possible to help you build a thriving school community in a secure way that connects the parents, the teachers, and everybody involved in raising our children. You know, over 30 years of research has already proven that the parental engagement and involvement is the number one factor to help make sure that every child succeeds and thrives most. And PTA as an organization has been there for more than 100 years trying to do exactly that, to create a sense of ownership among the parents, to create an environment where parents are connected and the community comes together to help every child succeed by either the resources, the volunteers, the funds, and every possible way to help our teachers and the school administration. But, you know, every 10 years or so, we have a new generation that is coming up that completely either consumes the information differently, that operates in a different way. So it's the one of those things where there's a new generation of the parents that are entering into the school system. Not only the new generation, but also the existing parents are all have become more social and mobile. Now, how do we make sure that the parental involvement and engagement continues to thrive in this new generation where people only consume bite-sized information? People only understand, you know, to operate in a network environment, and people cannot deal with too many pieces of information coming in too many places, so they need consolidated information. So that's where Bloomz comes in. You know, it really takes an approach of what has been proven in other parts of our lives, whether it is our professional world, our neighborhoods, or our personal world. We are connected with other parents, other people in networks. But when it comes to the school community, that's one area where it's still very traditional, or the very age-old approach of still getting the flyers, not having ability to easily reach other parents. And then the teachers being able to have a hard time reaching the parents when they need some instant help and so on. So none of the existing solutions really solve this. That's where we focused on building Bloomz, which is, you know, number one differentiator of Bloomz compared to any other networks is it's by trust. It's by invitation only. Because as parents and educators, we all care about the safety and security of our children. And we want to make sure that our parents are connected in a very secure and trusted manner. So every Bloomz community is initiated only with trusted leaders of that community. That's why we work through the PTAs and the school leaders. To summarize what Bloomz brings to your community to help increase the parental engagement is to first of all, help people to be connected in a community. Now people know all the other members of the community by relating to their face and name. And we were at one of the events this week at the Grand Ridge Elementary where they launched the community, and then they introduced Bloomz. And people were out in terms of, hey, we really love to be connected as a community. But what is the challenge is that we get to meet this 1 hour, and after that, we don't have a forum to stay connected. And that's where when we introduced the Bloomz, there was an excitement across the community, and they're getting ready to launch to the entire community in the next couple of weeks. And the next thing that the Bloomz does is really streamline the communications and coordination by helping these parents to be connected. As a parent, we have across multiple kids, multiple activities, multiple information sources, whether it is a PTA, the school, the classroom. It becomes a challenge for us to stay organized in terms of those communications. And Bloomz, again, helps you to pull together the calendars and also the people so that you have one place to really ask for information or seek, look for information or, stay connected with other parents. And from a PTA perspective, this creates a great opportunity for you to introduce a new medium for the community to stay connected. And parents, when they got onto these apps with all the last year rollouts that we have done, they felt like they have a whole new way to stay connected with the community. They understand more about what the PTA is trying to do. They understand the purpose, the initiatives. So it doesn't become one-way communication anymore. It becomes more of a two-way and a community-centric collaboration. And obviously, like when you're asking for volunteers and when other people are volunteering, I can see those updates coming in. So it naturally creates an awareness of, maybe I should volunteer. And it naturally creates a certain new behavior that is encouraging for even the PTA leadership, because that makes it easy for them to engage the community more effectively. Again, just to, as I summarized, we have great reception and interest from across the various PTAs. So we are very committed to making sure that those communities that are launching have every possible support from us. So feel free to ask us if you have ideas, because you have probably, as leaders of the your community, you may have introduced other programs and things that have worked for you. We would love to hear from you, and we want to help you. Whether it is a resource, whether you want certain materials, whether you want more information from us, whether you want us to do a webinar, whether you, anything that we can do for your community, we are here to help. And the other important thing that we focused on at Bloomz is to make sure that the apps are available across all the platforms. And in fact, there is a new native version of the Android coming very soon. We're just around the corner, so we'll announce it as soon as we feel it's ready for people to start using it. Before I get into the specifics of, what are the tips or the lessons that we have learned working with other PTAs that we would recommend for your community to embrace so that you can really launch for your community very effectively, I want to make sure that before I get into the next steps, I just want to summarize for you again. As parents, it helps, Bloomz helps really to consolidate and to streamline the coordination and to discover other people and resources and even local activities, or even just being able to ask other parents like, hey, I'm looking for a piano teacher, or I'm looking for this new swimming instructor. Does anybody have recommendations? Or just being able to respond to a volunteer request that came from a room parent or a PTA event. In any of those things, now I have one place to stay really organized and to be able to make sure that I'm staying on top of what is important in my children's life. And Bloomz is also, from the parent perspective, it's one piece is to connect with the school, but it also helps me to create my personal groups. Whether it is a carpool group or whether it is a study group for my kids, I can really organize my world around my kids in one place. Why that is important is because as a parent, you don't want to create one more island. You want to make sure that they have one place to really organize their world, and that's what Bloomz focuses on. And from a teacher perspective, again, we have a lot of PTAs where they are able to get the school and the teaching staff fully on board on Bloomz. And there are PTAs where only the PTA is really embracing Bloomz at this point, and then the school administration wants them to go ahead with the PTA embracing it initially, and then the teachers and the school administration want to embrace it as, you know, it gets more adopted. So in either case, there is value for the teachers. We are not here to replace any of the school mandated systems like learning management system, the attendance tracking system, or the grade books. We are not any of those tools. We are all about helping bridge the gap between the school and the home. These are things like, you know, quick updates that the teachers can give to the parents about what's happening in the classroom, quick reminders, class calendars, resources that, you know, parents would like to know. For example, if it is elementary school, you want to organize a birthday party, there are certain birthday party rules that the class may have, or pick-up drop-off rules, or just like a new assignment that is due, or a registration deadline. So any of those things that the teachers already have a need to communicate, but right now they end up using emails, they end up using, you know, maybe just the notes, which are hard to stay actionable. Right, as a parent, if I have something on my calendar showing up as here is an upcoming parent-teacher meeting, then I know that I can be reminded just in time, I'm prepared, I know I can plan to attend it just in time. So those are the value proposition for the teachers. Now when it comes to the PTA, you know, Bloomz essentially becomes your, you know, one-stop parent engagement solution. Because it's about, first of all, getting the community together. Next is to make sure that this community is communicated in terms of the events, you know, the schedules, the school calendars, the class calendars, or the photo sharing of all the events that are happening, asking for volunteers, sharing resources. It's also a tool for the PTA to organize their own committees, whether it is the board, you know, that wants to put together the minutes of the meeting. Every month or every time that they meet, they can publish those resources. It becomes a place for them to make sure that they are announcing the last minute alerts. Like it could be an event that is either getting, you know, delayed, or you're looking for the last minute volunteers. So every possible need of a PTA is essentially included. And over time, we have a lot more plans to make sure that this becomes a more all-inclusive solution for a PTA. And we will continue to keep this, the core of our app, at no cost. And as you can see here, you know, instead of using so many means of communication and reaching out to parents, now you have given them one place to, right on their mobile, to stay connected. And these are the various tools that we believe that we can essentially replace with Bloomz in a much more elegant and simple fashion. And the best part is that you're not trying to teach your parents or the parent community something completely new, because they are used to something like Facebook, they are used to LinkedIn, they're used to other networks and the tools that pull together the people, that pull together the value of community, that pull together the right events and the resources in a way that is easy for them to consume. Again, just to summarize, Bloomz is essentially focused on the safety, and our core philosophy is that we are more interested in growing it by trust, and at no cost we will compromise on that. All the information is secure and members own it, and we want to make sure that we build this trusted community. And by building this trusted community over time, we believe that there are other relevant resources that we can bring to the parents as well as the PTA and the teachers. So with this, I would like to get into the main agenda for this webinar, which is, in what are the simple steps that you can follow to really make sure that your community is starting to thrive. And we have seen this happen time and again. So, and I'm sure this relates to some of your past experiences also. Anytime when you introduce a new network-based approach, like Bloomz is an example, it really starts with the leadership. And that's where we want to work with you as the PTA leaders to embrace this first. So as the, I think most of you who have joined today, I'm pretty certain you have created a profile for yourselves as well as you have created a profile for your school community. And at this point, what I would do during this webinar is to take each step, and I'm going to jump into the, either the application and walk you through what are the ways in which you can use the app to fulfill those steps. Or we'll also walk you through some of the resources and point you to how you can use those resources. So the first step is to create a profile. Again, I'm going to switch to an app where we have created this demo environment. This is actually, we have taken a real world example and then we kind of changed it just to make it, you know, again, safety-wise and so on. We just wanted to preserve the integrity of those people and their information. So this is a reflection of a real world, but at the same time, it, the names have been changed, the information has been modified to, so that it is it stays relevant to everybody. So for example, right now I'm logged in as Helen, who's a PTA president. The first thing is, you know, if you have already completed the sign up, you know that when you open up your profile, the first thing we recommend is put up a picture, because community is all about connecting people. And the number one step is to make sure that you lead by example by uploading your own picture. And, you know, again, when you upload, create your child profiles. And remember that you have complete control in terms of who sees your child information. First of all, only the people that you are connected with can see your child information. And in the community, they are going to see basically the name of the child. So, for example, in my son's class or the son's school, I'm known as Samad's dad. And, you know, that's how, because every other parent recognizes me in the context of the child. So we recommend definitely that you upload your picture and give a context of what your role is, and make sure that every member of your PTA leadership is also doing that. So that's the first step to make sure that every other parent that is coming in, every other member that is coming in, automatically feels part of the community. So the next step is, let me orient you on the app itself. This is on the desktop, and if you have used the phone app works very similar to the desktop, except that on the desktop you have three panels. So you have the left tray, you have the main content panel, and you have the messages panel. And in case of a mobile phone, you are just going to have two panels, the left tray, which is hidden under the Bloomz icon. And one of the ways we have built this is, you know, I can simply represent a mobile phone experience by simply scaling it down here. So this essentially becomes your mobile experience. And when you click on the B, it expands your tray. That's where you're going to see your communities you're part of, the classes that you're part of, as well as the groups that you have created or you're part of. And at the top, you have a quick way to jump between, you know, your calendars, your messages, and your network. I'm going to expand again from the mobile view back to the desktop view so that we can focus on a big screen for you to consume the content. So on the left tray, we have the community. So this is the Albridge community, is the community that I would like to start and talk about. So anytime you as the PTA leader is essentially either creating a subgroup, creating a class inside your school, or inviting members to your school community, this is the primary area where you would be operating. That way, you know for sure that everything that you're doing is relevant to this particular community. So as you can see here, there are a couple of announcements that are already posted, and I can see a few of the updates from other PTA leaders. And you can share pictures, you can share resources, and info section is another section that we recommend that you populate. This is, again, none of this is probably something that you're creating for the first time. You probably already have it on your website, in which case you simply, you know, copy and paste it into your info section here. And then there is the events. This is where you're going to publish your upcoming PTA events. And as you start creating the subgroups and the classrooms, then each of them have their similar spaces. And as part of this walkthrough, I'll also show you how a teacher's experience would be at the next step. And then I go into the members section. This is where all the subgroups of our community, for example, this is a PTSA board. And by default, we automatically create a couple of smart groups, what we call. That is, every member that is invited, that is flagged as a PTA member, is automatically grouped under the PTA member. Similarly, anybody who is tagged as a board member is going to be tagged as the board member. And all other members, of all the members of the community are also browsable. So essentially, this becomes your directory. A directory that in the traditional sense is, you know, you print it out. One is, it's expensive to print it out. But also, it is not safe because anybody can leave it anywhere. That information is being shared or being used by any other person. Whereas here, by inviting the people and letting them control the community and communication, you're creating a new generation of directory that is more controlled by the members themselves. And then the classes is where your actual classes will be set up. So to start with, your profile, this community profile, you click on this icon at the top to be able to set up your profile. In this case, I'm logged in as one of the members who's been invited. If I'm also the PTA administrator, so I'm going to sign out and log in as another user and show you how. So when I signed in as the administrator of this community, Albridge Elementary, the first step is, if your logo and the branding is not already set up, it's very simple to set up. You click on the settings icon at the top right against your community, and you will see a couple of options here. One is, you can click on and pick a logo for your community. You can also choose the colors. And this is an option that you can control, whether you want members of your existing community. If you already have the entire list of parents of your community, then you can simply say only administrator can approve, and all you do is simply invite. And I'll walk you through the bulk invite process. But you can also enable this second option, wherein if you believe that you have access to, let's say, a subset of your entire school community, but you want this tool to be available to other parents, and you want to allow the existing parents to invite those parents, you can choose this other option and let them, you know, validate whether those are valid members of the community. So essentially, you are still growing it by trust, by inviting the trusted members and giving them the privilege to trust other, or the, verify other members. You can grow your community. So coming back, so we talked about creating your personal profile, creating a profile for your school community. We talked about adding the basic information as a community leader under the info section. And you can also upload resources right here. For example, when I click on a new section, if I have a document, this can be, if you're sharing this with all the PTA members, it could be an expense report that you want to share with any member that they can use, or it could be just the rules of the PTA. Anything that you have as common resources that you believe would be useful to the entire community as broadly, you can share it at the community level. If, on the other hand, if you want to share something only with your board, you would create a board group, and then you would only be sharing inside that board group. Now, after you've done the core of it, I'm sure, you know, we've seen most of the communities have invited their leadership already. So that's the second step. You want to invite your core PTA board and the school administration, and also invite your, again, if your teachers are completely on board, and if you have identified the room parents, the next step is to simply create the classes and invite the room parents. Now, creating the classes and inviting the room parents is extremely simple. It's there's always the quick link right here, and you follow create people or group inside your community. It gives you three options. You can invite members, you can create a subgroup, you can create a class. The distinction between a subgroup and class is that a class will have a specifically a teacher role. So when you invite a teacher, the teacher has more control of how the class operates. And whereas in the case of a group, subgroup, it is only for the group members that you invite. And it can be like a committee that you put together, the fundraising committee that wants to come together and make sure that they are all connected and they share the resources. It could also be a group that you put together for a sports group inside the school community. It could be dads only group. You know, you basically think about ways in which you want to encourage certain types of community behavior, and then you can create those groups and allow people to come into those groups and collaborate. To create a class, it's very simple. Create the name of the, give a name. Typically, you want to use the grade and the teacher. And it automatically gets associated. What that means is this class is now created inside this particular community. Now, at this point of time, it's the class is already there, so I'm part of now the class because I'm creating as an administrator. I can now invite the members to this class. So I can invite members to this class. As you can choose here, you can invite either the teacher. If you are the administrator creating it, simply create the invite the teacher to this class. The other simple step is, if you don't want to create all the classes, you can simply start with one thing, which is simply invite all the teachers to this community. And Bloomz automatically allows them to create their own classrooms. Now, to invite members to your community, all the teachers, all you do is click on the members in plus invite. And at this point, it gives me, do I want to invite to the community level, or do I want to invite to the subgroups of this community? Now, if I want to simply invite to the community, I choose that. And here, you can choose again the role of the members that you are inviting. If I'm inviting all the teachers, I simply choose the teacher. And if those teachers that you are inviting are also PTA members, you can simply turn on this flag saying that they're also PTA members. And again, I'm sure you've experienced this simplicity, wherein you can simply start typing the email. Let's say it could be a chaks@gmail.com, and you can simply type in, choose the email that you are inviting. Or this is where the bulk invite makes it extremely simple. Assuming that you already have simply the emails of all the people, I can choose a bulk invite. And all you need at the minimum is just the emails. But if you have the information about the first name and the last name and potentially which group they belong to, then you can use this. But our recommendation is to keep your life simple. Just start with the basic email. And if you have the first name, last name, start with that. I just want to show you a simple example here. The bulkinvite.xls. I'm switching here. This is an Excel file. Very simple. If you already have it in some other Excel format or database, you should be able to simply export it out and use an Excel format. The only thing I want to call out here is that you want to save this file as an extension called .csv. this comma delimited values. And by saving it in this format, it makes it easy for Bloomz to simply process all these emails. So I saved it in the bulk invite.csv, and then I would just choose that file. When I come back here, upload, I choose that file, and literally just right away processes. You know, there are four in that bulk invite. You could have, you know, 500 of your entire community right there. And what we recommend is that you separate members into based on the roles. For example, all the teachers, you put them in one spreadsheet. All the members, you put them in another spreadsheet. So in this case, if I want to invite these people as the teacher, all of them are in one spreadsheet. I choose the role and then simply click on invite. I can, if I'm uploading a member listing, all I need to do is choose the member. And if all of them that I'm uploading are the PTA members, I can also turn on the flag so that they all get a PTA member flag. And I simply invite them. So going back to step number two, it was about how do I simply invite existing board members by their email, or if I already have a spreadsheet of information for all the teachers, then I want to invite them. Bloomz is also a great tool for the room parent. You know, you make the room parent the class admin, and by enabling them to now collaborate with the teacher, they can actually use the class space to share messages about class events, ask for volunteers in the classroom. So now I want to switch to a classroom experience and then show you how that would work. So in this case, Krista White is the teacher, and as you can see, you know, right up front, she has the announcements of the school coming in, as well as her own announcement showing up. And this is, again, another great way for the parents to know what is important right at the top, as opposed to having to drill down and figure out what they need to stay on top. And as you can see here, we also have integrated, you know, RSVP and even volunteer coordination right within the app. Now in this case, I can see there is a curriculum night happening. And this is an event that has volunteer requests too. So I can see in this case that Baldwin Brown has signed up for something, and Vanessa has signed up for, you know, getting all the desserts. So and at this point of time, if I want to sign up for the cleanup of the items, even though I'm the, you know, this is an example of the teacher, it could be a classroom parent, and I simply sign up, and I can say I'm going to do all the cleanup of the items, and I want to be reminded 10-30 minutes before, and I'm going to sign up. So this again becomes a simple way for me to stay connected with the parents in terms of what's happening in terms of their events. And as a teacher, if I go inside my classroom, this is where my third grade Miss White classroom is. Again, I have an opportunity to set up the branding for my community, for my class. And for me, simply to share a regular update with the class parents is extremely easy. And I just choose the post option. If I did something that happened in the classroom, I choose the classroom, and I can, you know, choose the entire classroom or specific parents. And then when I'm done, I simply can upload files or attach images and then post a quick update. And most of the parents that have been, you know, teachers that have been using this are simply saying, you know, literally the one-liner blurb with a picture that says, you know, this is what happened at the field trip. This is what happened as one of the craft event that we did today, or here is the math lesson we talked today. So teachers are having an easier way to keep the parents in the loop with these quick bite-sized updates, which help the parents to really have the conversation at home with the kids when they come back, so that they can extend the learning at home very easily. So So the next step is, again, as the leaders of the community, you want to lead by example. So before you invite broadly your community, we recommend that you set up, you know, make some updates, share some events, sharing local events, sharing parenting tips that you think are relevant for the community, because you want to make sure that the community is feeling as if it is a tool for them. You probably ask them about, hey, what are some of the summer camps people have tried this summer, and what do you think about it? Because then people will start engaging. You make it a two-way conversation for people to participate, so that now people have a vested interest to keep this community going, and that naturally increases their participation in the main things that you as the PTA leaders care about, which is whether you want to raise more funds, whether you want more volunteers. Now it becomes easy for you to seek the participation from your community. I'm going to again switch back and sign in as an administrator. So some of the things that we recommend that you typically want to try it out are the best way to introduce Bloomz has been in few of the upcoming events. And one of the things that you want to do is you want to go ahead and set up some of those calendar events, but also ask for volunteers as part of those events. As demonstrated here, if you have a curriculum night, you know, asking for volunteers right here. Similarly, if you, you also encourage the room parents to do the same thing in terms of asking for volunteers. Now, I want to focus on the next example, which is creating awareness. The best way to introduce Bloomz is when you have an upcoming event coming up. But you also want to create the buzz and awareness through multiple mediums. So what we have done is we have created a new support site. I want to switch to our support site. You can access the support site also from within the app. When you click on the support, it launches View Support Center. So you click on the support center, it takes you to our support site. And we've actually spent a lot of time to make sure that it is organized in the most appropriate way based on the role of the user that is coming in. For example, most of you as the school PTA leaders, you want to start right here. You know, if you already understood what Bloomz brings to you, it's really the next step is how do you get started as a PTA leader. We have also put together FAQs. But more importantly, as you get ready to introduce Bloomz to your school community, we have resources for you to introduce Bloomz to your PTA board, which is one of them is this PowerPoint deck. There is also the teacher brochure. What is Bloomz is the PPT is the PowerPoint that I just walked you through. There is also a teacher resource. So this is a flyer you can print out, and it really summarizes for the teachers what they can do. Here again, it's very simple. It asks them to recommend them to create a profile, build a class community, and the tools that they can use, whether sharing class updates, sending reminders, or doing instant secure messaging with the parents. They can do all of this in one place. So this is a flyer that's very easy to print, and it's easy to download from our support site. We recommend that you simply download that, print it up, and share it with the teachers. And the other thing that we want to help most of the initial communities is we are happy to do that for you. If you tell us an approximate date or when you're launching to your community, we can put together a whole welcome kit of, you know, a number of teacher brochures, a number of brochures that you can introduce to your parents. We are happy to do that because we want to encourage you to take that step of being able to launch to your community very easily. The second thing I want to switch back, I'm a PTA leader. We also have the resources that you can use to introduce Bloomz to your parents. Here, we see that currently you are using already a number of these current mechanisms, whether it is a newsletter, whether it is a website you already have, or you're using the email to send it. Some of you may have a Facebook page or a Twitter means to share. So one of the best ways to bring the people on board is to use your current means and to introduce Bloomz. So it could be simply if you're using a newsletter, simply take this material. Most of it is already customized so that it is relevant to you, but you can further tweak it to put your specific name of your community. Similarly, here there's an email message that you can share. There are Twitter posts that you can simply use. And we also publish a number of images of the app so that parents can right away can relate to what the app can do for them. And there is also the Bloomz logo and then the parents flyer right here that you can use to share with the with your, so for example, if I click on the PTA flyer, so this is a simple one-page flyer that helps you to print it. You can send it through the room parents, you know, as are the classes and teachers that can print this and share this along with the students' folders. Or you can also use this flyer at one of your events that is coming up and then share this, because the actual invitation itself is going to come to the members through their email. But this is a way to create the awareness and buzz before you actually roll it out to your community. And we are again here to really help make it easy for you. So if you have done in other ways in the past that have really worked for your community and you want us to put that resource together, we're 100% committed to supporting you in that. And then final step before, once you feel like you have created the awareness, you have seeded the community, you have gotten the most of the leaders on the app, then the next step is to invite the community. Now, when you invite the community, the things that you really want to do is to help with the things that matter to members in terms of welcoming them. So I'm going to go back into the app. So as you can see, as people are joining, connecting, you know, you simply want to encourage them by welcoming them, welcome him, welcome all to the classroom if they are part of the classroom. If they are in the community, you welcome them to the community. So what this naturally gives them is a sense of association back to the community. And then as we talked about some of the best practices of continuing to regularly share a local resource or something that is happening at the school level. It's also a great way for you to create advocacy, or like, you know, there is a new initiative that you want to launch in your school community that requires a lot more parents to embrace that, or you're raising some new funds. So these are all the great ways in which you want them to feel privileged to be part of the community. Naturally, the next steps would be to get them to participate more and more.